Hello friends, this video on basic concepts of chemistry part 1 is brought to you by examfear.com. No more fear from exam.
Objectives of this lesson: understand and appreciate the role of chemistry in the different states of life. We'll explain the characteristics of three different states of matter. We'll classify substance into elements, compounds and mixtures. We'll understand the SI basic units and we'll list some common prefixes for that. We'll use scientific notations and perform simple mathematical operations. We'll differentiate between precision and accuracy. We'll find significant figures. We'll convert some physical quantity from one system to another system. We'll explain various laws of chemical combinations. We'll appreciate the significance of atomic mass, average atomic mass, and etc. We'll also learn molecular mass and formula mass. We'll describe terms, that is mole and molar mass. We'll calculate the mass percent of different elements in a compound. We'll determine the empirical formula and molecular formula of a compound. And we'll perform some stoichiometric calculations. Since we have a lot to cover in this lesson, we'll not go deep into these topics, but the objective here is, since most of these we have already learned in the past classes, the objective of this lesson is just to brush up our past knowledge so that we are more comfortable in understanding the next chapters. What is chemistry? We all know what is chemistry, but let's understand it once again. Chemistry is nothing but it's a science of atoms, molecules and their transformation. Please note, chemistry is nothing but science of atoms, molecules and their transformations. We talk about atoms, we talk about molecules and we talk about their transformations. Correct? We can also say chemistry is nothing but a branch of science that studies composition, properties and interaction of matters. So there are various definitions of chemistry. These two definitions I feel defines the maximum chemistry, right? So it talks about chemistry is nothing but science of atoms, molecules and transformation. And this talks about the chemistry is nothing but science that studies the composition of a matter, properties of matter and interaction of matters. Correct. So having understood the definition of chemistry, let's understand why should we study chemistry. We have done this in the class 10th, but let's again do this. If you see the diamond, that's a carbon, that's element, and this study of diamonds now comes under chemistry. If you see the coal, you want to understand the property of coal, how it burns, how much heat it will give for a X amount of coal. Those things you can find using chemistry. If you see the plastic materials which we use in our life, example is a water jar, the plastic, CD player, CD compact disc, bottles, cleaners, all these things involve plastic. And the formation of plastic needs a knowledge of chemistry, because it is the chemistry which has given this plastic to us. It's a not a, a the natural thing, a synthetic thing that is synthesized in the labs. And to do all these things, to generate these plastics, the knowledge of chemistry is a must. The soaps we use, it's all the chemistry which gives soaps. This liquid soaps also, it's a gift of chemistry. The detergent which you use, the study of detergent, everything comes in the chemistry. The fiber, the fabrics which we use, that also is has a chemical property, and we study the chemical property of these fabrics, and thus the study of these also comes under chemistry. The plastic toys we use, again it's a plastic, so it comes under chemistry. The notebook we use, that's part of chemistry, because we try to form the composition of the notebook. The pencils has the wood and the graphite, everything comes under chemistry. The erasers also you make using the knowledge of chemistry, right? The tea we have in this, the sugar, here also we talk about chemistry. The burning of any substance, the chemical reaction, it's called oxidation. The wines, the beers, everything, the manufacture of those things involves knowledge of chemistry. The petrol and the diesel which we use in the car, that involves knowledge of chemistry, because that, for example, with chemistry knowledge, you can see that this particular fuel will give this much energy when you burn, or this much carbon dioxide when it burns. Those kind of stuffs we learn in chemistry. The LPG which we use in our home for cooking gas, that also needs a good knowledge of chemistry. The fertilizers we manufacture, different kind of fertilizers, some are acidic, some are basic. That depends on the kind of soil you have, right? So those things also comes under chemistry. The pesticides we use, also comes under chemistry. The medicines we use when we fall ill, when we get cold or any kind of issues in our body, we use medicines, and those also comes as part of chemistry. So with this, it is pretty clear that chemistry has a huge application in our day-to-day life. Whether we talk about the fuels we use, the toys we use, the pencils we use, the dress we wear, the plastics we use, the medicines, the soaps, detergent, most of the things, chemistry is involved. And that's very that's the reason why chemistry plays a critical role in our day-to-day life. Now the question is, can we count the number of atoms and molecules in a given matter? You already know what are atoms, what are molecules, right? You must have learned the definitions of atoms and molecules in the previous classes. The question that comes to your mind is, can we count the number of molecules or atoms in a given mass of matter? For example, let's suppose I have 10 grams of, let's suppose anything, 10 grams of gold, right? So in the 10 grams of gold, how many atoms are there? Can we count? So these kind of questions chemistry will help us answer. Can we see the atoms and molecules? Maybe even another question, because we know atoms, we know molecules, right? So we know definitions of atoms, molecules, we know. In fact, we also know how to divide up atoms into protons, neutrons, and electrons. The question is, can we see the atoms? So those kind of answers we'll try to cover with this lesson. Advantage of studying chemistry. We have told that chemistry plays a critical role in our daily life, where we see that when you use plastics, diesels, petrols, a lot of things, chemistry is involved, right? So what is the advantage of studying chemistry? So if you see that with better understanding of chemical principles of any object, right, it is possible to design or synthesize new material. For example, if you see, if you want to create something which has high magnetic power or high electric properties or low optical property, any kind of thing we may require for engineering purpose. So if we have better understanding of the chemical properties, we can create such kind of stuff. Correct. Also, for example, earlier we used to use CFC, chlorofluorocarbons, for fridge and refrigerators, right? And that was not environmentally safe. Those were all hazardous things, right? So this was responsible for ozone depletion. So for this, the safer alternatives has been synthesized. And how it was done? Because we had knowledge of chemistry, we know the properties of these CFC, and then the chemists around the world, and they created a better alternative to CFC, which has all the things we need for fridge, but which doesn't lead to ozone depletion. So because we had a problem, we knew that there is something which we require for fridge, but that also caused ozone depletion. Now, since we had the knowledge of chemistry, we know the chemical property of the substance, we were able to synthesize. And that's, if you see, even achievement of chemistry, right? So this is a real life problem we had, that we are using CFC in the fridge, and that's depleting our ozone layer. That's pretty bad. So for that, the chemist came to a solution, and we got the solution. So the chemistry, since most of the things around us is a matter which has chemical and physical properties. So if you have a better understanding of chemistry, so you can solve real life problems. One of the examples I gave is this, that CFC was causing ozone depletion. But again, this was critical because that was used in fridge and refrigerators that we use in our day-to-day life. So for that, the chemist found a safer alternative using the knowledge of chemistry. Still, we have some problems with the chemistry. I mean, not the chemistry, but we still have challenges which we can tackle with a better knowledge of chemistry. For example, the greenhouse gases like methane, carbon dioxide, we know that these gases have these properties and it causes greenhouse effects. We are still looking for a better solution for this so that we can minimize the greenhouse effects, right? Also, the biochemical process, the use of enzymes to large-scale production, these things are still in the nascent stage. Chemists around the world are still exploring on these, and maybe we can find a better solution, right? So because we know that enzymes play a better role, you put enzymes and the chemical reaction doubles or triples, right? So we want to know why it works, how it works. Those things are still pretty much unexplored territory now. These are again the challenges with the chemists now, and they're working on this.
Thank you. Visit examfear.com too Watch free educational videos, try free online tests, get the best quality study materials, study from the best tutors and mentors, and much more. Thanks once again.